Hello friends, today we are discussing application of electrochemical series. Alright, so this is electrochemical series based on E0 value or E0 value, electrode potential, standard electrode potential. If the metal ion concentration is 1 molar and temperature is 298 Kelvin, alright, the measured electrode potential is called standard electrode potential. On the basis of this, we have prepared a series called electrochemical series. This is also called electromotive series, electrochemical series or electromotive series or activity series. Alright, this has some application, so it is better to learn this table. To learn this table, you can do one thing, like lithium and rubidium. Alright. Lithium or lithium like rubidium and potassium. Lithium like lithium like rubidium, potassium also travels in Bascanamil. Don't look at the spelling. Bascanamil, just like Guruvayur Express or Punjab Mail, etc. A train. Alright. So, like rubidium, potassium also travels in Bascanamil from Zinc Fekoni. This is a station, Zinc Fekoni, to Tirunelveli. Pub. Like rubidium, potassium also travels in Bascanamil from Zinc Fekoni. This is a station, Zinc Fekoni, to Tirunelveli pub. Alright. So these are the members above hydrogen. Alright. See, like this is lithium, rubidium, potassium. Alright. Travels in Bascanamil, barium, strontium, calcium, sodium, magnesium and aluminium. Bascanamil from Zinc Fekoni, so there is no problem. Zinc Fekoni to Tirunelveli, that is for TN, tin, alright, tin and PB, lead. So this is all the members above hydrogen. Like rubidium, potassium also travels in Bascanamil from Zinc Fekoni to Tirunelveli pub. Alright. And after that, hi sis, somebody telling to his sister, hi sis, you know, mercury has a low boiling point. Mercury has low boiling point. Say then, hi sis, you know, mercury has low boiling point. It is said in cafe. Said in cafe. So see, hi, this stands for hydrogen, this is for copper, iodine and silver, this is for mercury, low boiling point, bromine and platinum, this stands for chlorine and this is for aurum, gold. And flow for fluorine. Kyle says, you know, mercury has low boiling point, said in cafe. Alright, so like rubidium, potassium also travels in Bascana mail from Zinc Fekone to Tirunelveli pub. And then Hyas says, you know, mercury has low boiling point, said in cafe. So these are the members from electrochemical series. I have taken some important elements. Alright, so this is electrochemical series. Now look at the variation. It is minus 3.05 volt. This is minus 2.37 volt. This is minus 0.14 volt, minus 0.13 volt, hydrogen 0, and then bromine. Chlorine is plus 1.37 volt, bromine is around 1.08 volt, and fluorine it is 2.87 volt. Positive. All right. Copper plus 0.34 volt. This is the order of electrochemical series. You must remember this series, and it has so many applications. So that is why I am telling you to remember this series. All right. Now, see, the first application is reducing ability is inversely proportional to E0 value. That means we are considering the sign also. So that means lithium has the lowest value of E0. Alright, we are including the sign. Reducing ability is inversely proportional to E0. Or metallic reactivity in aqueous media is also inversely proportional to E0 value. Metallic reactivity in aqueous media. Whereas you should be careful, metallic reactivity in gaseous state, this is in aqueous media, metallic reactivity in gaseous state is inversely proportional to ionization energy. Alright. So suppose we are given some members, like we are given magnesium, or we are given tin, or we are given aluminium, or we are given suppose copper. Question is, which is the strongest reducing agent? So, if you know the order, you can say out of these four elements, magnesium is at top, and obviously it is having a lesser value. So, obviously the correct answer is magnesium. Alright, or suppose some values are given. Say suppose it is given minus 2.37 volt. Some members' values are given minus 1.66 volt. Or minus 0.44 volt, or it is plus 0.79 volt. So on the basis of value also, you can say this is the strongest reducing agent. Sometimes to confuse us, it is given Li positive. All right, and say suppose we are given sodium. All right, and say suppose we are given cobalt and nickel. So Li is in positive state, that means it has already lost electron. So obviously the next member is the strongest reducing agent. So you should be careful. Alright. Same goes with metallic reactivity. So this is the first application. Reducing ability is inversely proportional to E0 value. Lower the E0 value, less stronger is the reducing ability. Alright. So this is first application. The second application is oxidizing ability. Oxidizing ability is directly proportional to E0 value, and non-metallic reactivity is also directly proportional to E0 value. Or if the question is choose the strongest oxidizing agent, choose the strongest oxidizing agent. Suppose we are given iodine, alright, bromine, chlorine and fluorine, or some values are given, plus 0.54 volt, plus 1.08 volt, plus 1.37 volt or plus 2.87 volt. If elements are given, if you know the order, you can say fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent, or on the basis of value you can say this is the strongest oxidizing agent. But if we are given iodine, bromine, Cl negative and F negative, now the correct answer is Br2, because chlorine and fluorine, they have already accepted electron, now they cannot accept electron. So the next member is bromine, which is the strongest oxidizing agent. Alright, so this is one application of electrochemical series. Next point, next application, greater the difference between E0 values of two reacting species, greater the difference between E0 values of two reacting species, faster is the reaction rate. Greater the difference, faster is the reaction rate. Suppose we are given which couple shows fastest reaction. Suppose we have say nickel plus iodine, or we have zinc plus bromine, or we have calcium plus chlorine, or we have lithium plus fluorine. So this couple shows fastest reaction rate. And faster is the reaction rate, greater is the amount of heat released. That can also be compared. Alright. Greater the difference between E0 values of two reacting species, faster is the reaction rate. Alright. And the most important application is any member can reduce the below placed one. Any member can reduce the below placed element in the series, or any element can oxidize the above placed element in the series. Like lithium can reduce rubidium, rubidium can reduce sodium, sodium can reduce nickel, nickel can reduce silver, silver can reduce platinum, platinum can reduce fluorine. Or fluorine can oxidize chlorine, chlorine can oxidize iodine, iodine can oxidize iron, can oxidize barium, barium can oxidize lithium, like that. So this is the most important statement, and we get questions based on this. Suppose which arrangement is proper or correct. Suppose we are given copper sulfate in a container of zinc. Copper sulfate is stored in a container of zinc. Or we have, say, suppose silver nitrate is stored in a vessel of aluminium. Or we have ferrous sulfate stored in a vessel of copper. Or we have, say, suppose we are given calcium nitrate stored in a vessel of zinc. Alright, the question is which arrangement is proper, whether copper sulfate can be stored in a vessel of zinc. This is the question. So see, zinc is in atomic state and copper is in ionic state, as copper 2 positive. Alright, so if there is a reaction between zinc and copper, it will be like this: Zn2 positive plus copper. Now the question is, zinc is getting oxidized. If the oxidation number during a reaction, if the oxidation number increases, we say that the species is oxidized. So zinc is getting oxidized. So if zinc is oxidized, its function is reducing. Zinc is oxidized, the function is opposite. It is acting like reducing agent. Zinc is reducing copper. In this reaction, zinc is reducing copper. So the question is whether zinc can reduce copper. Look at the series. Zinc can reduce copper because copper is below zinc in the series. That means this reaction is possible. So if this reaction is possible, that means this arrangement is not good. You should not store any salt solution in a vessel made of more reactive metal. Always a salt solution should be stored in a vessel of less reactive metal. Like look at this case. Again, silver nitrate is placed in a more reactive metal. Alright. So obviously there will be a reaction between aluminium and Ag positive. And reaction will be like this. Alright. So in this reaction, aluminium is getting oxidized. That means aluminium is reducing silver. Whether aluminium can reduce silver? Yes. That means this arrangement is not good. You should not store silver nitrate in a vessel of aluminium. Alright. Look at this case. Here, Fe2 positive. If there is a reaction, it will be like this. Copper 2 positive plus Fe. So copper is getting oxidized. That means copper is reducing Fe. Whether copper can reduce Fe? No, copper cannot reduce Fe. That means this reaction is not possible and this arrangement is good. So any salt solution can be stored in a vessel of less reactive metal. Less reactive metal means below. Alright, these metals are less reactive. Gold, platinum, they are less reactive metals. Alright, as you move upward, this reactivity increases. Alright, I told you metallic reactivity in aqueous media is inversely proportional to E0 value. So this arrangement is also proper. Now look at one more question. Out of these, which of the following reactions are possible? Which of the following reactions are possible? We are given Cl2 plus twice of Ki, that gives twice of KCl plus I2. Or we are given chlorine plus KClO3 gives KBrO3, twice of KClO3 plus Br2. Or we have Br2 plus twice of KClO3, that gives twice of KBrO3 plus Cl2, like these. Look at these reactions. Which of the following reactions are possible? This is the question. Now look at the first question. The oxidation state of chlorine decreases from 0 to minus 1, means chlorine is reduced. And if chlorine is reduced, that means the function is oxidizing agent. So the question is whether chlorine can oxidize iodine. Whether chlorine can oxidize iodine, any member can oxidize the above placed one. Chlorine can oxidize iodine. That means this reaction is possible. Alright. Now look at this case. Chlorine 0 to plus 5. That means chlorine is oxidized. If chlorine is oxidized, that means it is reducing bromine. Whether chlorine can reduce bromine? Chlorine cannot reduce bromine. Chlorine can oxidize bromine, but chlorine cannot reduce bromine. That means the second reaction is not possible. Look at this case, bromine 0 to plus 5, bromine is oxidized. If bromine is oxidized, that means bromine is reducing chlorine. Whether bromine can reduce chlorine? Yes, bromine can reduce chlorine. That means this reaction is possible. Alright. Now see, The next application, the same application is same, the next question. Suppose we are given some ions, like we have magnesium 2 positive, we have say copper 2 positive, we have Ag positive and we have Au3 positive. And this is the aqueous solution, alright. And we have taken one cathode and one anode. And we are this the cathode and anode both are made of inert electrodes like platinum or carbon, etc. In that case, the question is the sequence of deposition of these ions, the sequence of deposition of these ions over cathode. Alright, so the point is, see, as we move downward, the electron accepting tendency increases. As we move downward, electron accepting tendency increases. So Au3 positive is at the bottom. So Au3 positive goes first to the cathode and it is deposited first. After that, silver positive is deposited. And after that, copper 2 positive is deposited. Alright. And after that, magnesium should deposit. But magnesium cannot be deposited at cathode from aqueous solution at inert electrode. So this point we will discuss later. That is preferential deposition of ions. Preferential deposition of ions. Alright. That we will discuss later. So magnesium 2 positive cannot be deposited at cathode. So this is one application. And next application is any metal oxide can be reduced to metal. Any metal oxide can be reduced to metal provided that metal is placed below hydrogen in the series. Provided that metal is placed below hydrogen in the series. For example, suppose we have silver oxide, alright, plus hydrogen, you will get H2O plus twice of Ag. This reaction is possible. Again, basically the statement is also from the previously mentioned statement. Any element can reduce the below placed one. See, hydrogen is oxidized. If hydrogen is oxidized, that means hydrogen is reducing silver. Whether hydrogen can reduce silver, yes, hydrogen can reduce silver. So any metal oxide can be reduced to metal on treatment with hydrogen, provided that metal is placed below hydrogen in the series. Hydrogen cannot oxidize, cannot reduce Al2O3. This reaction is not possible because aluminium is above hydrogen. Alright, and one more application is any metal oxide can be reduced to metal on strong heating. Any metal oxide can be reduced to metal on strong heating provided it is placed below hydrogen in the series. But this tendency increases downward. Suppose we are given, say, suppose silver oxide, alright, silver oxide is given. So we have Ag positive and O2 negative, alright, we have Ag positive, O negative and Ag positive, O negative, alright, Ag2O, Ag2O. So when it is heated, see, I told you as we move downward, electron accepting tendency increases. So when this metal oxide is heated, the force of attraction between oxygen and the extra electron decreases. And these two electrons are lost and these two oxygen combine to produce oxygen and it is gone, oxygen. Alright, it is evolved. Now, since these metal ions, they have tendency to accept electron. Again, downward, electron accepting tendency increases. So, these two electrons are gained by silver. Alright. And it is converted to silver metal. So any metal oxide can be reduced to metal on strong heating, provided that metal oxide is placed below hydrogen in the series. This tendency of course increases downward. That means suppose we are given copper oxide, silver oxide and platinum oxide, and the question is which metal oxide is reduced to metal on strong heating first. So our answer is platinum oxide. Alright. So these are some applications of electrochemical series, and we will be discussing the preferential deposition of ions from aqueous media in a different lecture. Alright. Hope you are enjoying the series or the new series, and you please give your valuable comments so that I can improve. Alright. And whatever you want, you if you mention it in my YouTube channel, you can enter my name Ramesh Panikkar, and you can subscribe it alright on YouTube. So all the best.